values, ladies and gentlemen, that we must make the case for men, women and children as one unit, with women taking their equitable and democratic place in the society. I believe that for our success as a nation, we must return to our culture, true nature of our creed and religion. Ladies and gentlemen, it is our government's firm commitment to build a society grounded in our indigenous values, where all Pakistanis, regardless of their gender, religion, or creed, or age, are given the dignity they deserve. We envision a Pakistan where justice, freedom of thought and choice, and a peaceful, secure life is available to all. We aspire to build a nation free of the tyranny of dictatorships and oppression, free of poverty and fear, a nation where a dream and hard work are all that is required to turn opportunity into success. Where there are challenges, ladies and gentlemen, we see a wellspring of hope. Pakistan today is home to remarkable individuals whose courage, dedication, and talent humbles me daily. Malala Yousafzai became the youngest winner of the Nobel Prize for her tireless campaigns for girls' education. Shirmeen Ubaid Chinoy became the first Pakistani to win Academy Awards, inspiring thousands of women. And then, ladies and gentlemen, most of all, we celebrate the life of Shaheed pilot Maryam Mukhtar, who broke the barriers of sound and life alike in service of the country. And who would dare forget the blood of Shaheed Benazir Bhutto, with which the soil of democracy in Pakistan is still drenched. We can never lose hope. We can never lose hope because of our strong tradition of female leadership that dates back to the Prophet, peace be upon him's era. His wife Khadija, who was among the most successful and wealthiest of traders in ancient Arabia. Fatima Jinnah, who was an equal partner to Muhammad Ali Jinnah in attaining the independence of Pakistan from colonial rule, is amongst our greatest heroes. Female heroism, ladies and gentlemen, especially, is a part of our tradition. And I firmly believe that women, especially in our part of the world, can rise with tradition rather than rising against it. I ask that we amble forward for the simplistic notion of mere inclusion in society to roles of leadership being awarded to women. Women parliamentarians, as yourselves, are in the unique position of heralding such change in our society, championing other women, encouraging them and promoting their causes from the seats of power is at once fascinating and challenging. I urge you to appeal to your inner selves to be the harbinger of good news for your female compatriots. No woman should be left because she must have you espousing her rightful place in the march towards betterment, towards social justice, and ultimately harmonious democracy. Behind every successful woman, ladies and gentlemen, is not necessarily a successful man. It can also be a tribe of successful women who have her back. Since its inception, ladies and gentlemen, WPC has served as an emblem of the pledge